Good day. Followers of the Way International, and even many former followers of the Way International, considered founder Victor Paul Wierwille to be an excellent writer, author, and researcher. In fact, all of the Way International's theology and practice is based on the writings of Victor Paul Wierwille. The magazine even said that it's his works that can tell the Way International which verses of the Bible can be deleted or which ones can be revised. His courses provided the basis for the beliefs and the origins of the Way International. The group produced a book called The Living Word Speaks, which talks about how his writings are of great volume and great quality. The Way even says that Victor Power's writings were unique and original. They were based on the Bible alone. They weren't like tradition in denominations. And Wierwille even claimed that God spoke to him audibly and said that God himself would teach Wierwille the word as it hadn't been known since the first century. Well, it's good to look at Victor Paul Wierwille's writings. What are his books like and where did they come from? They'll tell you something about the writings themselves and about Wierwille and what kind of man he was. Pretty much you can categorize all of his books and writings into pretty much three kinds. The three S's. Well, the first S, or the first kind of Wierwille's writings, was shallow. Studies in abundant living and parts of Jesus Christ is not God, victory in Christ, and other writings are really just simple sermons. He will quote one verse of the Bible and then talk about it for a few sentences, and then quote another verse and talk about that for a few sentences, like any simple sermon would be. Now, it's easy to produce a book this way. It's not really writing a book. All you need is an audience you can preach to regularly, plus a tape recorder, plus a transcriber. Wierwille's former secretary and sister-in-law, Rhoda Wierwille, says that she transcribed all of his speaking and condensed it into a book, Power for Abundant Living. Just transcribed talks. Now, it's easy for any pastor of any church to produce a 500-page book every year doing this method. It actually isn't writing at all. You just preach, someone else transcribes, and you have a kind of a book. But it's a shallow way to write a book. And shallowness in Wierwille's case leads to sloppiness, too. Let me give you an example. The book Jesus Christ is Not God, he wrote, and he claimed that this was solid proof that Jesus Christ does not have a divine nature as well as a human nature. Now, there's one chapter in that book called Common Errors in Understanding, which is actually verses of the Bible that talk about the divinity of Jesus Christ. Well, this was originally a talk he gave, tape 295, if you want to look it up, which was later transcribed and became a chapter of this book. Well, it's interesting to see how shallow these things are. These are important verses of the Bible to study to discover who Jesus Christ is. And yet, in nine of these verses, he just gives a one-sentence explanation of why it doesn't say what it says. And then another four verses, he just gives two sentences to refute them. Others, just three sentences. It's so shallow and superficial and sloppy. And yet, it's promoted as though this is serious research in a groundbreaking book. You can contrast theological writings that are really theological writings, and most people from the Way International don't know what serious theological writings actually look like. For example, Kittel, a word book of Greek words, would devote several pages to just a single key word in one of those verses. And so a real interpretation of them seriously would have to be much more detailed, but Wierwille's just shallow and sloppy, and that's an example. They consider Jesus Christ is Not God to be a book that soundly refutes the traditional teaching of the church about Christ Jesus. And yet, it's like full of white space. If you actually count the words in it, it's really only about maybe eight magazine articles all stitched together. It's really sloppy and superficial. Another example of sloppiness is Power for Abundant Living. Wierwille talked about Enoch in Hebrews chapter 11, that he didn't see death, and his proof was the Greek word is anableptō. Well, the Greek word wasn't that. Later on, they had to change that in their books, but didn't change the interpretation. In other words, he knew what he wanted the verse to say, and it really didn't matter what Greek word was used, and he just made that up as he went along. There's often times in his teachings when he appears to be teaching from his heart, when he's actually reading from notes in the Companion Bible. So this is the biggest category, perhaps, of Wierwille's books. It's, well, shallow and sloppy. Well, there's another category of his books. This is what you might call subbed. That is, they're subcontracted to substitute writers who write the book for him. The fat books in the Way International, like Jesus Christ, Our Passover, and Jesus Christ, Our Promised Seed, were actually written by the research team, not by Wierwille. At best, he should be called a contributor or an advisor, not even a general editor, much less an author. But he promoted his reputation this way by having other people write the books for him and putting his name on them. Now, the acknowledgments mention that he had a research team, but not that they wrote the book for him and he didn't write it himself. This is, well, subbed books, to add to the shallow ones. But there's a third category of his books as well, which is really important. Now, Wierwille's claim to fame was that he repeatedly said he studied the Bible itself, and this is where the teachings came from. Not tradition, which is what other denominations and people did by studying the books of others, but rather truth from the Bible itself. For example, in the book Receiving the Holy Spirit Today, Wierwille specifically said he did not use any books by any other people to write this. Just use the Bible alone. He says that plainly in the preface. In Power for Abundant Living, he said he took all his theological books to the city dump, dumped them, and studied the Bible alone to get his teachings. In The Way Living in Love, Wierwille said that he heard God's audible voice, and God said God would teach him the word as it hadn't been known since the first century. God would directly teach him by revelation. And this is what his followers basically believed. And so it's especially surprising that in exactly those books that he claimed he didn't use people's books, he plagiarized them thought for thought and word for word. Most of Receiving the Holy Spirit Today is plagiarized. A big chunk of it from J.E. Stiles' book, which is called The Gift of the Holy Spirit, published in 1948. Another large section of the book is taken from Bollinger's book, The Giver and His Gifts. In fact, every part of Bollinger's books, Wierwille takes and put in his own, pretending that it's his own, never once noting in that book that material is taken from Bollinger or Stiles. In fact, if you delete all the things from Stiles' book and Bollinger's book, you have hardly anything left in Receiving the Holy Spirit Today. Another book of Wierwille's, if you can call it that, is called Are the Dead Alive Now? Big chunks of it were copied from Bollinger's book Selected Writings and another Bollinger book called How to Enjoy the Bible. Part of New Dynamic Church was copied from Kenyon's book, The Father and His Family. These are just a few examples. Wierwille had a lifelong problem for like 40 years of plagiarizing other people's books and pretending, foisting them on the public as though they're his own writings. The plagiarism is especially obvious in early editions before other editors got around to cleaning up his prose, making it more readable. Now, this is completely different from learning from, and people confuse the two. Some people say, well, Wierwille said he learned from some other people, and so plagiarizing is okay. Well, plagiarizing is not the same thing. Plagiarizing is copying people without footnoting them. Anyone who's been to middle school or high school or college knows you have to footnote in the same book or article the author you got material from. When they're direct quotes and when they're indirect quotes, Wierwille never mentions Bollinger or Stiles in his book, Receiving the Holy Spirit Today. He never mentions Bollinger in his book, Are the Dead Alive Now? Much less footnotes them. Students get F's on their papers when they plagiarize. Professors get fired. Journalist gets fired for plagiarizing. The Christian world should have more integrity than the secular world, not less. And yet, Wierwille's followers will defend his blatant plagiarism. Now, there's proof of this. I wouldn't want you to go without that. There's proof of this in monographs in which Wierwille's writings are printed side by side with Bullinger and Stiles, so you can see for yourself. We'll send you photocopies of his plagiarism if you want to compare it for yourself. This is very plain. And it shows not only that he's dishonest in plagiarizing, it also shows that his claims to use the Bible alone are false. He falsely made those claims to promote himself. Okay, so there are stolen writings, there are shallow writings, there are sub-writings. What does this tell us? It tells us Victor Paul Wierwille was not a writer. He didn't have the skills, he didn't have the patience or discipline it takes to write. He didn't have the integrity or research ability to write. He liked to shoot from the hip when he taught. And so that led to sloppiness and inaccuracies and him making up stuff. He liked to grab strange ideas from other people and claim they were his own. And there are books, most of them, that are written by others, either written by a research team or written by others that he plagiarized, that aren't his writings at all. Now, the Way International and those who believe its teachings really rest their belief on the integrity and the writings of Victor Paul Wierwille, that he's really the only source of truth and you can't find truth in other places. That's their claim. And they base that on the research, the authority, the teaching of Victor Paul Wierwille. They trust Victor Paul Wierwille as the teacher, they call that, or the man of God for our day and time. And they really believe that he is the source of truth and everyone else is tradition. And really, in essence, they base their faith more on Victor Paul Wierwille's interpretation of Bible verses than on the Bible itself. And that's why some of you listening right now are upset with me questioning the basis and the origin of Victor Paul Wierwille's writings. And you'll defend Victor Paul Wierwille for things you'd condemn other people for doing. Because your beliefs, the beliefs of so many people, are based more on the writings of Victor Paul Wierwille than on the Bible itself. Victor Paul Wierwille's lack of integrity, lack of accuracy, lack of truth, lack of integrity and authority is a faulty foundation on which to base your beliefs and the teachings of the Bible. It's a faulty foundation. It's part of the rotten roots of the Way tree.